side here, so some hand. I'm gonna take the anterior suspension. See on the side. Is that over through here?
Can come around here. Around to the side. Yeah, to the side so you can see it.
I must have a little
tie out. Yeah.
I'm not going to bother retying. It's just to show it in that suspension. I'm just going to attach it again here. But normally, all you really need to have is the line. Others. This is called Lawson. This is a jungle hammock. This one has some spreader bars. I'm not going to bother setting it up. It also has a rain tarp, which is the next thing that we're going to talk about. With tarp works is you can use anything from a simple little poly tarp. You can get for a few dollars. It's cost me $3. It's a 6x8 tarp. It's about the right size for this hammock stand. Just barely over a normal size hammock. This little base tube tarp is much bigger. You get a good coverage out of the leather. And this Kelty Noah's tarp is a 9x9 tarp with cat cut edges, so it handles the wind a little better, stays tighter. It's the favorite outdoor tarp. It comes with nice light pegs and rope and everything you need to tie it down. It also keeps some extra lines in there. And pegs, aluminum and titanium ones are the lightest. I tend to like these kind because they're easy to pull out and nice to pull in. These are nice and strong. The lines are super, super strong. A bunch of these are nice. All you really need are two, but I'm going to use three and show you one trick. Right, put the tarp on. If you have a ridge line, that'll help to hold it up a little bit. But the main idea of the tarp is you tie this out, and it's called a diamond configuration. So you get one side tied down to a peg over here, another side tied to a peg on the other side. And the traditional way to do this is just to use a loop down here. You can again use your little sheet bend. We're going to do something different, and what happens is when we normally get in a hammock, this thing will loosen up. Unless you have it tied directly to the trees, it takes extra line, it takes a lot. So I tend to like just to tie this directly to the suspension. The problem is when you sit down in it, the whole thing loosens and stops being tight. So what we're going to do is tie one end to one corner. Tied to this corner. Put a peg. your knee. And it's high, it's called a spot. Can you see that okay? So underneath, what I'm doing is, use one of these ends. I'm doing a tight taut line hitch. Just loop it over twice. Back. Loop it over again, tie a knot. What that does is gives you a little knot, sort of like the trucker's hitch, that will slide along and let you tighten down on it. So as I pull that tight, you get a nice, you can look up at a taut line hitch, you get a nice tight pull on both sides. You can kind of pull this in and tighten it as much as you want. Now when you get in the hammock, looser, so all you do is pull on the taut line hitch when you're in the hammock. Keep it right beneath you, and that tightens up. I just put the peg over here. That tightens up the knot so that you can be nice and tight inside the hammock, and none of this looseness is around. And that works really comfortably for setting it up. This dirt here is really loose, so I won't pull too tight on it. Helps to have a little bit longer peg. Doesn't happen. I'm going to redo the taut line hitch, show you how to do all that. Just pull the knot loose. A little bit of a mess on the taut line hitch. Typically when I tie a taut line hitch, I do the same thing I do with all of the other knots. And I put a bite through so I don't have this really tight end. So I'm going to do that again. Show you with a bite. Again, here you just take one end, wrap it around the inside twice, wrap it around the end twice, come back around. Do you see that knot? Mm-hmm. And then here, what I'll do is take the end, and again, instead of pulling the whole rope through, just pull the bite through. So again, you've got one that you can just undo really quickly. Works really well. And tighten that up, and that cinches down and holds it tight. So when you get in, carp just got loose as I sat in this. You just pull on that a little bit more, gather up all your slack on both ends. You got the carp nicely buttered. We're going to do this in trees so you can see how the setup works on the lines. But that's the basic. It's the basic setup. It's a little bit loose here because it's not quite long enough for the hammock stand. But in the tree setup, we're going to set this up so you can cinch it tightly, you can adjust where you want it. I'll show you some tricks about setting up these things. I usually put two or three in at the same time, crisscross them. That keeps them from coming out, even if they're nice and short. So, 6x8 tarp gives you just enough cover to cover your hammock. Bigger tarp will cover much more than you actually need. We'll do that in the next video.